Okay, so it's still 90 degrees in Boston. Oh, I think it's going to break tonight, but because of that, the windows are open. I do have the fans off for the sake of audio quality, which means I am internally dying inside. But if you hear birds or cars, forgive me. We'll really test the efficacy of this microphone today, but let's talk about what I've read, because I have read some things, I've finished some things. I'm in the middle of so many things, but I have finished The Unbroken by C.L. Clarke. I really, really liked this. I have a spoiler-free review that's going to be going up, and I was a part of a book club, so I'll have that link down below. We talk spoiler-free for the first, like, 20 minutes, and you get to hear, like, four people's perspectives, although we all largely really enjoyed this, so probably won't be very helpful for, like, negative opinions, but this was so good. What an unexpected surprise. I'm so glad I bought a copy. I cannot wait to see where this series goes. But I also really like that it ended in, like, a good place, so I'm not just like, ah, but where's the second book? Because I have no clue when the second book's coming out. I also finished New Suns. This is the short story anthology that I have just, like, blown through. Whenever I pick up a short story anthology, I say, like, one story a day, because I don't want to overburden my mind with all of the world building. Because honestly, world building in a short story can almost be more intimidating than, like, a long novel, because it's just, like, you have to get in, like, right away. But I think there were 17 stories, and I read it in, like, 8 days. It was a really, really solid collection. Like, not everything was a slam dunk for me, but it was really good. And I made a Storygraph and Goodreads review that I'll have linked down below that, like, talk about some of the stories that I really like. I don't know if I will do a video for this collection as, like, a standalone review, but if there is interest for that, like, if you want me to do a video review and, like, talk about specific stories that I really liked to give you a taste for what might be in there, let me know, and I will. I have nothing against it, but it would just be like, I don't know. I currently don't feel the need to, especially because I wrote those Goodreads reviews, so you guys let me know, but I finished that. So that's two prompts down for the readathon, so I'm feeling pretty good. Now, what am I in the middle of? Let's start with the audiobook, because I always forget that. Lord of Chaos. I think I'm 40% of the way through. I don't really have that many thoughts right now. Like, it's not doing anything that bothers me. I also don't think it's doing anything super interesting at the moment, but it's not an unpleasant audiobook experience. Yeah, I mean, I think there are some characters that are doing some growth that I really like. I think that's one of my big complaints, right? It's like, I haven't seen the growth yet, and I want the growth. I also feel like a lot of characters are still, like, so suspiciously absent from POV moments. So we'll see what happens. I still don't really know where we're going. I still sometimes feel the clunkiness in the plotting, where it's like, oh, we need these people to, like, leave here and go somewhere else, so we're just gonna, like, make a MacGuffin reason for why they need to leave. Like, I feel like that's almost always the motivation, is we have to go to this place to get this thing, or to investigate this thing for this reason, and just always, I never feel the motivation is really strong, but it's fine. But enjoying the audiobook, it's good. I definitely don't, like, pay, like, super close attention, so, like, sometimes there are chapters where a bunch of people are, like, conniving, manipulating things, and, like, I think I'm supposed to be intrigued and engaged. But I'm mostly just like, okay, these people are up to no good. I'm excited to see when that, like, comes to fruition. But opposite side of the coin, but another epic fantasy, I am this far in Memories of Ice, which I have made a lot of progress. I'm doing about a chapter a day of this because they are long chapters. Like, 20 pages of a Malazan book is like 45 minutes of reading for me. It takes me so long. But I annotate, I take notes. I am really liking a lot of the world building and lore reveals. I love all the banter. I feel like that's what I always say. So I'm gonna have a spoiler video. I'm still enjoying this. I also still think it's kind of funny that it's called Memories of Ice, and this cover has fire on it, which is important for the readathon, but doesn't really make sense for, like, I don't know. Like, and I do like the title because I think it makes sense to me, and, like, the history that's kind of taking place in this world's ice age that we're, like, keep referring back to and exploring. It's just a lot. We also have, like, a hashtag reluctant hero hour, which, like, this feels like an earned reluctant hero that's in this book. So I'm having pretty standard great time with this. I've enjoyed revisiting a lot of characters that were in Gardens of the Moon and learning more. It's still, like, I was actually talking to Alan from the Library of Alexandria. He was asking me where a particular character was, and I was trying to, like, lay out everything I knew, and it's like, there's just so much. But it's all so cool to me, and I would totally understand if a lot of people, like, didn't think some of the things that I think are cool. Like, it's really just, like, I don't know, there's just like a lot of cool magic. Like, I think that's the thing. It's like, this feels epic and vast and magical and awesome. And that's just like, it's speaking to me. Like, I can't read these all the time. It is not like my favorite type of dense writing style. But reading a chapter a day has been really fulfilling. Okay, I have another ebook. I have two ebooks that I'm reading. So let's start with Lagoon by Nnedi Okorafor. This is for Poseidon. And I am liking it. It's very, very plot-based. It's very plot-driven. I think that's what I'm trying to say. The heat is getting to me, guys. I'm dying. This might be a shorter video because, like, I'm dying. But, so this is plot-based, which is cool, and it's very, like, intriguing at the beginning. You, like, start in the lagoon and, like, a thing comes from the sky and interacts with the wildlife there, and you're just like, but what's gonna happen next? And it's just action from there. But kind of because of that, I'm not quite feeling it right now. Like, I don't think I want an action-paced book. I don't know. Like, there's nothing wrong with it. It's definitely really cool in that it's set in Nigeria. And I'm really glad that I've read other Nigerian works because I feel more familiar with the contemporary setting we're in. Because I read The Thing Around Your Neck by Chimamanda Ngozi Adichie last year. And so a lot of the, like, political tensions and a lot of the things in the area, like, I feel informed by reading those more literary fiction short stories in this contemporary space. But it's just definitely interesting to read a sci-fi in a country where I normally don't get to read sci-fi stories, especially in, like, contemporary day. There is, though, because of that, like, there's a whole point of view group of people that speak, and I forget what it's called, but it's a different dialect that, like, I've been looking it up and I've been looking up dictionaries, but I can't make it flow smooth in my head. So I feel like I'm missing things when I read those sections. Like, I'm not quite getting what's being said, but that's, like, okay. I can accept when a book is not written for me and my cultural sensitivities. Like, this doesn't feel like a book that was written for me growing up in the Midwest to consume. It feels like it was a sci-fi book written for other Nigerians, which is fantastic. And I'm enjoying it. I just, like, I don't know, I don't feel the urgency, even though, like, things are going down, like, things are crazy. And so when I finished New Suns last night, I was like, you know, I'm not really feeling something this fast-paced, I kind of want to sit in something. And I was like, you know, it sounds like the perfect time to start a new fantasy that I've heard is kind of more like slow-build character work, and that's The Jasmine Throne by Tasha Sori. I think I said that right, Tasha Sori. Guys. Could this be the month where I get 2 5-star fantasy reads that are new books, that are new releases? It could happen. It's too early to tell. I'm in very, very early days. And, like, I won't be upset if it's, like, 4.5 or 4-star. That's still, like, a fantastic reading experience. But because I'm in this mood to, like, get to know a world and people and kind of, like, explore and just walk around, but it's still lighter than Molasses. It's so good. The prologue is so intriguing. You start off with this king and something's happening with his sister and you know something's not quite right and you're like, what's going on? So, like, the intrigue level's just, like, there. One of our point of views is, like, someone with, like, a mysterious past and I'm like, yes, there is some magic. There's, like, a kind of, like, curse magic. There's historical lore. There's political tensions. I am really intrigued and liking, and the writing style. I've never read a book by her. I want to read it's kind of a duology, the two companion novels in the world. I think one might be called Empire of Sands and the other one's like Realm of Ash. I could be right, I could be very wrong, but I have heard amazing things about those, especially like in terms of like quality fantasy romance, but I haven't read them yet. They're on my list, the never-ending list. But I picked this one up because I had an arc and oh my goodness, the writing. Like, this is one of those books where, like, I can really, like, imagine the atmosphere of the place that I'm set in and really get a good sense of, like, the feel of the location. Because that's kind of how, like, I interpret visuals in my head is, like, sometimes if I'm lucky, if someone describes a thing that I do have, like, a clear picture in, like, my memory back catalog, I can bring it forward. But most of the time, I can't just, like, create rooms in my head. But, like, sometimes the way she describes things, I'm just like, that was fantastic. That was masterful. So I'm really excited. It's still early days, but once I finish the chapter that I need to read of Memories of Ice today, I'm going to pick that one back up as, like, my evening read. Because, like, I'm just feeling it. I'm just feeling, like, slowly getting to know people in a world and seeing what's happening. Because it's, like, I don't know, I guess that's just what I want right now. And I also have, like, a little mini book haul, because apparently that's what I do all the time. if I do them in little chunks, I'll never have to actually film a whole book haul video, and I'll never know how bad this buying habit is getting. But I only bought one of these, and I bought House of Chains, which I believe is the fourth book. It better be. If not, I need to buy the fourth book in Malazan. I just figured, since I had Memories of Ice, I needed to get House of Chains for when I read that in a few months. And, you know, I just wanted to see how much bigger it is. I think this one has better font. No, the font's about the same. But the spine's a little less tight, so that's nice. It's a little more meow. I don't know. We got doggos. The doggos typically are attached to the Shadow Warren, I think. And I know there's stuff with Perrin. I don't really know. There's doggos. I feel like I don't get anything from this cover art sometimes. I'm just like, I don't know what's happening. But they keep getting big. They're gonna look nice on the shelf together. I do love the satisfaction of like a stack of mass market paperbacks. And then the other one's a gift, so I didn't buy it. But when the person asked if I wanted it, I did say yes. And that is Sorrowland by Rivers Solomon. I have a review for this, so I'll link that in the cards. Evie bought herself a copy, but a friend also gifted her a copy. And so she was like, do you want a copy? And I'm like, I guess if you don't want to return it, I'll take it. And so I'll have Evie's channel linked down below. She's a lovely member of the community. If you don't follow her, she's hysterical. And she's like, I don't know. She's like the master of buddy reads and readathons. She just like does all the things. She actually just posted a video about a bunch of readathons she's going to be in. Not readathons, more like read-alongs, like for certain authors and series, etc. This book's fantastic though, and it's so pretty. Like, I really, really love it. It's like such a nice blue, and I like the height. I don't think I knew what this really looked like in person, and I really like the cover. I don't know. I'm just excited to have it. And it's the same height as The Deep, which is my other River Solomon. So like, they look so nice next to each other. It makes me so happy. So that's my little book haul, and that's this video. That's what I've been reading. I don't know. I think my goals are kind of to finish Lagoon before the next check-in for the readathon, which I can for sure do. I only have like 2.5 hours of reading left. I just need to find the motivation to care about the story, which is a me thing, not the story's problem. The Jasmine Throne, like, if I got some good, like, stick a nose in book times, it's gonna be great. But I am going up to New Hampshire this weekend. We have some family stuff going on, so I might not have that much time to read, which is totally fine. But if I do, it's gonna be great. And that's it, I believe. What are you watching, reading, playing, etc.? Ooh, how do I always forget this? Like, I'm like trying to sign off. I played the Red Rising board game. Is good. I mean, okay. It's a card management game that is completely overproduced because it's by Stonemaier, which if you're not in the board gaming world, Stonemaier is just known for making really pretty board games. Like, there's one that most people know is Wingspan or Scythe. Those are the two that are like the most popular, but they bought the Red Rising rights and they made a Red Rising game, and it's about combos of cards together. Like, you want to have a hand of cards with the most points, kind of like Rummy, sort of like Rummy. It's similar to those type of card games where you like start with a hand and you want to maximize it to points. So each turn you get rid of cards, gain cards, that type of thing. And the combos are so thematic to the book. It's great. Like, neither of my friends who own the game have read the books, and I'm like being like, oh, this is so cool that you want to have this person with these two people because they're friends. And so if you are a fan of the material and want to see all those combos, and I think it's a solid game. I think it's a good like game for all level of gamers. Like, I don't think it's like very highbrow and like you need to like read a rule book that's 20 pages long or anything like that. It was fun. So that's the thing I did. I also played other games, but that's like a book-related game that I thought I'd tell you about. We also played Champions of Midgard, which is like a great Viking game, and I finally won. I'm not bad at that game, but I never win, and for once, I dominated. I was the most Viking of Vikings. It was fantastic. So those are the games I played last weekend, because I got to play games, and maybe I'll get to play games this weekend, because I'm seeing my mom, and although we have plans and we'll be busy, my mom brought games because I have converted her. And it's fantastic. So let me know what you're doing in any form of media. I'd love to hear it. And otherwise, an emoji. I don't know. The Jasmine Throne. I don't know. I don't know what Jasmine's a flower, and I have Sorrowland, which has plants on it. Let's do flowers. I don't know. I just make things up. So flower emoji if you just want me to know you're here and you don't have like anything to say. And like if you liked it, subscribe if you want to, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.